Come on.
They speak with their lips, but their heart is far from them. They want a blessing from God, but yet when the house of God is open, they are not here. And we wonder why. It's because their heart is far from God. Yes. Their heart is deceitful. Who can know it? Only God can know it. God will show everybody's heart where it is and what it is. He will test you by your words of your mouth. He will test you by the action of your people, of your place. He will test you by everything that you are.
Yeah.
And we want to know why God is not moving in these last days, because our hearts are far from Him.
Come on. Yes. Preach, take your time.
We want to know why the palmer worm. What is a palmer worm? As we read here in verse 4, it says the palmer worm, it is a chewing locust that eats on fruit. We notice that the pomegranates and the apple trees and everything is mentioned here. The palmer worm eats the fruit. That's just like the devil. We'll come down here to the house of God and we'll get them saved. And then a few weeks later, they're back out into the world and they're back. It's because the fruit, the devil is after the fruit. He's after the fruit of the ministers of God. He's after the ones that are getting saved, the ones that are getting filled with the Holy Ghost, the ones that God's people is bringing in. He's after them. When we look at the locusts, a swarming locust, grasshoppers with strong powers of flight, utterly salating, but from time to time, solitary, but from time to time, there is a population explosion. We want to know why the church of God is not full in these last days, because there is a population explosion of the devil in these last days. We look at our nation and we look at everything that's going on. Our nation is running rampant in sin. Our nation is running rampant in homosexuality and lesbianism. Our nation is running rampant in alcoholism and in dope and drugs and drug addictions and everything. We look at Cersei right up here. It used to be open, but it's closed right now because a woman who did not want to drive all the way from Dolphin Island, Alabama, to Mount Vernon, Alabama, to help people. But the world cannot help them. The only one that can help them is the men of God, the women of God. That is why we have to be more faithful in these last days. We have to be more faithful to prayer. We have to be more faithful to fasting. We have to be more faithful to the house of God. We have to be more faithful than our Bible reading. We have to be more faithful than anything in our life. We say we're faithful to God's house, but yet when it comes time to be in God's house, we're not here. And we wonder why God ain't moving in our lives. It's because we're not faithful to God. We're not faithful to Him. And a canker worm, what is a canker worm? A crawling locust consumed the buds. The buds. The buds is the early blossoms of a tree or of a plant or of the bringing on of fruit and leaves of the trees. When it chucks out, this is just like the parable that Jesus gave in sowing of seed and everything. We wonder why the children of God is getting choked out in these last days. It's because we do not preach against things.
Yeah.
We do not preach against sin. We want to give them a feel-good gospel, but yet lack the convicting power of the gospel. We need the convicting power in these last days.
Yeah.
Without the convicting power of the Holy Ghost, there is no gospel.
That's right. Come on, you're preaching
the good. The caterpillar, consuming locusts. After the palmer worm, the locust, and the caterpillar, the canker worm have eaten up everything that is there. The caterpillar comes in and eats everything that is left. That is just like the devil. He's not going to stop at getting you out of the house of God. He's going to destroy you from the top down. And when he gets you on the bottom, when he takes you, he's going to send in the last blow, which causes you either to die out or to die. Oh, I rebuke you, devil, in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
It causes you to die out. It takes and eats everything. That's what the devil wants. He wants everything. He don't want to stop at nothing.
Yeah.
He don't want to stop at the little thing that causes you to backslide on God. He wants to take everything in your life out. He wants to take everything.
Everything. Preach, brother.
Habakkuk. Habakkuk 2. And there appeared, that ain't Habakkuk. There's Habakkuk. Habakkuk 3, 2 and 3. For the vision is yet for an appointed time.
Yeah.
But at the end of it, it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Even though what's going on in our life, even though what's going on in this world, even though what's going on in this story in Joel's time, it is the same. We look at the Bible and everything, it is the same. From the beginning of the church, from the beginning of God's time to now, it is all the same. The devil does not come at you in any other tactics. He does not come at you with new ways. He always comes at you with the same ways. He always comes with you with the glamorous lights of sin.
Yeah.
We look at Lot. We look at Lot. He pitched his tent towards Sodom. Why did he pitch his tent towards Sodom? Because his heart was not with his uncle Abraham. His heart was with the world. And we wonder why people of God, well, so-called people of God, are not in the house of God. Because their heart is not with us. Their heart is against us. They have lost the vision. They have lost everything that there is of God. They have lost their hope. They have lost their life. They have lost everything, and they wonder why God's not moving. He said, it will not tarry. We have to tarry. We have to get on the altars, and we have to pray for it. We have to intercede for it. We have to move. We have to. If they won't move, we can move them with our prayers. We can move them with our intercession. We can move them with our will, with our fasting and everything. We wonder why the gates of hell cannot prevail against the church. It's because the church will always pray. The church will always beg. The church will always call out and weep before God.
Yeah.
We need the vision. If we lack the vision, we perish. Behold, his soul which is not lifted up in him is upright in him. But the just shall live by his faith. By his faith. That is what we got to live by. We got to live by his faith. We got to live by Jesus Christ's faith. We cannot live by our own faith. We have to live by the one that come before us. The one that went to the cross and died for us. He said, though, every day pick up your cross and follow me.
Come on.
He said, do not pick up yourself. It says, pick up Jesus and follow him.
That's right.
We need to follow Jesus more now than ever.
Amen.
It says, ye also, because he transgressed by wine, he is a proud man. That is just like the devil. He's going to build up pride in you, but we have to humble ourselves. We have to humble ourselves before Almighty God. He said, the ones that humble themselves and are of a contrite heart shall see God move. We need to humble ourselves before an Almighty God.
That's right.
He is a proud man, neither keepeth that hope, who enlarges in his desires as hell. The devil, the hell is enlarging every day. It's because we are failing to go out into the highways and the hedges and compel them to come in. We can't sit on the pews anymore and expect them to dart the house of God. We have to go out into the highways and the hedges and compel them to come in. We are lacking the biblical stance of evangelism today. It's because we're not going out into the highways and the hedges and compelling them to come in. We want to know why God's not moving. It's because we're not going where God can move.
Yeah.
We expect God to stay in four walls instead of go out into the highways and the hedges and tell them to come in. Compel them.
Yeah.
And there is a death and cannot be satisfied, but gathereth unto him all nations and heapeth unto him all people. The devil does not want to stop at the church. He wants the whole world. And we have to stand at the foot. If we have to stand at the gates of hell, devil, you're not going to prevail against God's house. You're not going to prevail against God's people. You're not going to prevail against anything. anything that you think you can prevail against. But I'm telling you, there's some people up here in Mount Vernon, Alabama, and down in Mobile, Alabama, that's going to stand for God no matter what. There's nothing in this world that can stop you. There's nothing in this world that can stop us. But I'm telling you, we're going to walk up in the gates of hell.
Come on,
we're
going to
take our people back.
That's
we're
right.
going to take the ones that need to be saved. We're going to take the ones that need to be delivered. We're going to take the ones that need to be healed, that need to be set free, that need to be moved and moved into the kingdom of God. Devil, you cannot have them. You cannot have nothing in this world. But no, the only thing that you can have is the pits of hell. The only thing that you can have is the lake of fire. And your day is coming very soon, devil. And you cannot prevail. You cannot prevail against anything that is in you. You cannot prevail against anything that God has told you. You cannot prevail against any one of God's children. Because I'm telling you, he said he is faithful to his children. He'll never leave us nor forsake us. He will be with us through everything. He will be with us if we have to walk into the pits of hell and grab our loved ones up out of there. That is what prayer is. When we lay down and we languish before God, prayer is the death to bind their souls into heaven. Prayer is to bind the revival spirit in the church today. Prayer is to bring about God's will. Prayer is to bring about the moving and operation of the Holy Ghost. And prayer is everything that we need to do.
Yeah.
We do not need to do anything else but pray, but fast, and but seek God's face in these last days.
Yeah.
Woo! Woo! Glory! I'm telling y'all, God has been really dealing with me. I'm telling you about prayer. I'm lacking it. I'm telling y'all. I'm lacking prayer. I'm just praying that God gives us, that God is forgiven. And I'm telling you, I know he is forgiven, because I'm going to tell you, if he wasn't forgiven, he wouldn't allow me to stand up behind this pulpit. And he wouldn't allow me to give forth this message. We need to get back to prayer, people. We need to get back to intercession before God's people. We need to get back before weeping before the altars and the porch of hell of the house of God. We need to get back to praying and fasting and seeking and laying in sackcloth and ashes. We want to know why God moved so mightily back in the early 1900s. It's because the people of God prayed. We want to know why God moved so mightily for William Seymour and Azusa Street, because he went from 8 hours a day to praying to 10 to 12 hours a day of praying. Yeah. Intercession for the city of Los Angeles, California. And he seen the mightiest move of God that a man could ever see in his day and time. We want to know why. Why Smith Wigglesworth seen such miraculous healing services. We want to see why he seen the dead raised, because he was a man of prayer. They call him the apostle of faith because he was a man of prayer.
Yeah.
We want to know why A.A. Allen or R.W. Shambach seen moves of God in their time. It's because they was men of prayer. They was men that was totally concentrated over to God's people. They was men that was totally concentrated over to God's will and God's word. We want to move. We want a revival in Mount Vernon, Alabama.
Amen.
We want a revival across Mobile, Alabama. We need to get back to prayer.
That's right. That's right. Preach. That's right. Get back to prayer. Prayer. That's good.
Glory.
That's good. Glory.
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 Glory to God.
We need prayer more than ever. It says in Joel chapter 2, blow ye the trumpet in Zion and sound the alarm. The church needs to sound the alarm that the kingdom of heaven is at hand. The kingdom is coming. We see the signs fulfilling every day. But the church is so caught up in popularity. The church is so caught up in prosperity. They're so caught up in everything in the world, bringing every bad that's underneath the sun into the house of God. And they wonder why God's not moving. Because they're not blowing the trumpet in Zion. They're not telling the people to repent of their sins. You want to know what Jesus' first message was?